goods. Only purchase of goods on credit are recorded in purchases book, but not any other credit transaction like purchase of an asset on credit, or let us say adjustment entries or closing entries at the end of the year based on accrual concept, etc. We don't record in purchase book. Now similarly, purchase returns book is nothing but when you purchase goods on credit, you have the possibility of returning them back to the suppliers due to several reasons, like they are of not specified quality or due to some damage or etc. So whenever you return the purchased goods to your supplier back, we record in purchase returns book. So we record transactions related to goods returned back to the supplier. Next, sales book. So in this, just like purchases book, in sales book we record only credit sale of goods, that is goods sold on credit, that is goods sold on credit are recorded in sales book. Next, sales returns book. So when you have sold goods on credit, your customers have an option to return them due to some reason. So if goods are sold, goods are returned, we record in sold goods when they are returned. We record when sold goods are returned. Next, bill receivables book. A bill receivable book records bills received, or when we draw bills on our customers or debtors, we record the transactions first in bill receivable book. Similarly, in bill payable book, we record the transactions when we accept bills drawn by our creditors. Next, the last one is journal proper. So if you see, if a transaction doesn't belong to any of the above subsidiary books, then we record it in a journal proper. Now, briefly, let us understand again. It is very easy to understand. So cash book, only cash transactions. Now, this four books, that is purchase books, purchase returns books, sales return books, are related to goods, that too goods purchased on credit, goods sold on credit. Then you can say these two books are extension of your purchases book and sales book only. So if you basically see, these are dealing with credit transactions. So you can say from 2nd to 7th, these books are dealing basically with credit transactions. And that too, mostly they are related to our purchase and sale of goods. Coming to journal proper. So if the transaction is not related to goods, then naturally, and it is not a cash transaction, it is recorded in journal proper. So what would be the transactions that will be coming in journal proper? For example, we say an opening entry. Now what is an opening entry? In journals you have read, wherein by you have written the first entry based on accounting equation, wherein by you used assets minus liabilities is equals to capital, that concept, and recorded it as a journal entry. So that is what is written in journal proper. Basically you can say in journal proper we record the transactions like journal entries, but in all other things we use a format in which we simply state the reason and enter the transactions. Now other, so we write in journal proper what all? We write opening entries, to, you can say, closing entries. You can say so I'm writing here, we write opening entries, say closing entries, say rectification entries, you can say adjustment entries, then transactions relating to assets, public nominal accounts. Later when we prepare journal proper, we will discuss these transactions. Stop change.